shall address the collective length of time to honor senior class of 2022. This group of seniors have given 100% in the rest of the room and in the classroom, and have played a key role in the DuBois success. First up, Blake Weglars. Blake is escorted by his parents, John and Lisa Weglars. He will be graduating.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for tuning in to tonight's broadcast. Your Loras College DuHawks taking on the Wartburg Knights. Right now, what we got going on, it's senior night here tonight for the DuHawks. We got Frankie Indinelli. He's coming out tonight to thank the coaches, and he's had a hell of a career here, academic All-American. We want to thank Frankie for all he's done for us. Kid's going to go on and be a doctor. I think he'll do all right. Next, we've got Brock Timmons from Davenport Assumption and his family. Brock's been one of my favorite guys to watch over the years. Really unorthodox style of wrestling. Heck of a top wrestler, as most of the kids that come from Assumption are. But he's been a great asset to our team as well. Here we go. We got Brady Vogel coming in now from Kansas. Brady came to us from Iowa Central and has been a starter in the lineup for a couple years, a couple different weights. Tonight he's going to be going at heavyweight for the DuHawks. Thank you, Brady, for everything you've done for us. And last but not least, multiple-time All-American, Jacob Krakow, one of the hardest-working guys I've ever been around. In the room, outside the room, everything in between. We're going to miss Jacob. He's done a great job for us. So, Worm, the backdrop is set for tonight. Number one versus number two, number 1A versus number 1B, however you want to put it. However you want to say it, the gym is packed. I mean, absolutely packed.
My opinion, this is the national final duel. This is the duel that everyone really has been talking about all year. Loras didn't get the opportunity to compete at the national duels this year. And Wartburg, I believe, had to pull out as well. So we really didn't know who is the best team, and we're about to find out tonight, I think.
Right.
Just as you were doing all those introductions, I look over, and all of a sudden the Wartburg section just filled up their students. If you guys can see on our cameras, it is absolutely packed on the lower side. Bear with us tonight, guys, because this is going to get loud up in here.
Yeah, it is. It's the marquee, like I said, this is the marquee matchup of the year. These are the two best teams in the country going at it tonight. No doubt about it. It's for the last 4 years, this has been the duel between two of the best teams in the country.
Absolutely. Before this time, within the last 4 or 5 years, I mean, if we were lucky to get 6-12 points on Wartburg, we thought we were really coming along. And now, 2 years ago beating Wartburg, last year we had a little downtrot. I think we got a team that can do it tonight as well. This is like the word big fight feel gets thrown around way too much in our sport, but this definitely feels like it in Dubuque, Iowa tonight.
Yep, and it's going to start off right out the bat at 125 pounds, where we got to get off to a fast start in every match, but it's going to start with Jared Hensley, and it's going to end tonight with Brady Vogel, and it really, it's going to come down to it. These matches are toss-ups. You can't give up bonus points. But you got to go out and get bonus points.
Absolutely.
The crowd is nuts right now, man. I am tingling. I mean, this is absolutely crazy. It is going crazy in here.
I've never seen this. This is unreal.
Like I said, I think tonight we're going to have mainly our conventional lineup, and we'll see what Warburg's got going on in a couple different weight classes. They have a couple different guys, so, but no matter what, like I said, these are all contested matches, super important for the regional coming up, and this is the beginning of the battle, right? I think the end of the war is D3s, but this is definitely the beginning of the battle, so this is exciting stuff.
This is a fun environment. This is going to be a fun environment.
There's absolutely, positively, no D3 duel that's ever been as crazy as these duels have been in the last couple of years. I mean, you can throw out Augsburg and Warburg all you want, but this is nuts.
I mean, we're almost at standing room only. Like, I was just saying this before we went on the air, you know, there was nights where we'd have this duel in Graber, and there might be close to 30, 40 fans. And that right now we're about to be standing room only in Ellis. So here we go, man. Like, this is fun. Let's get these – where are the nights at, man? Like, we got to get them going.
You know, here in Iowa, we've got districts going on tomorrow. So top two go to state. A lot of districts across the state here. And I know I see a lot of kids in the crowd getting ready to go. And this is going to pump them up for sure. And – for everybody viewing at home, thanks again. Like I said, this is our last broadcast of the year. It's been great. Worm, you've done a great job being my compadre, as always. And, you know, thankful to be able to get this these broadcasts out to our fans and everybody else across the country that's not able to make these duels, you know, whether you're in California, Louisiana, wherever you're at. So thank you for tuning in. These broadcasts have gotten better and better over the years. These students do a great job with the production. And here comes Warburg. They're coming out. Not much needs to be said about it.
Nope, not at all. And there's only one thing left to do. That we can talk all night. I mean, I feel like the fans are going to get tired of us. But at the same time, you know, it's about to get to a point where all we can do is fight. So here we go.
We're getting on to introductions here soon and the national anthem. But I tell you what, this is the environment you want, man. Everybody wants this stuff for the sport of wrestling. This is how you grow wrestling. You know what I mean? People say D3. Oh, what's D3? Well, I tell you what, you look at a crowd like tonight, this is bigger than some D1 duels.
Of course, I agree with you on that 100%. Just got to put a good product out. At the end of the day, you got two teams that both like to compete, both like to lay it out there. Fans are going to show up. All right, Duhosh, we're going to get through the introductions here real quick. I want to give a special shout-out before we start off in memory tonight. The former Warriors Duhawk, Alex Graff, passed away this August. In the words of him, turn up.
Yep. All right, here we go.
At 133 for Loris, Aiden Evans.
Again, the keys to the matchups tonight, like you kind of talked about. I mean there's a lot of favorites on paper for Warburg. We got to go out there and fight and turn the tables.
Gary Cole at once said, you control the match, you control the crowd. Loris goes out and does their job. There's nothing that anyone can do between the tables. There's nothing that you want to be better than the ref. You got to be at least 5 points better than the ref, always. In this situation, you control the match, you control the crowd.
And I tell you what, we couldn't ask for a better ref in the conference. He's the best ref that we have in the conference. I'd love to see these duels have two when they're this hostile and this loud. But you know what? I trust that Rick Stahl is going to go out there and do a great job on both sides tonight.
Wholeheartedly. Probably one of the best around. Big Ten ref, NCAA Finals ref. Obviously, they don't give that job away, so he's definitely earned a spot.
Like I said, there is a couple weights where Warburg's got a couple different guys weighed in. We'll know who they are. We'll be letting you guys know who's wrestling. And big applause for Krakow. And we got some number one versus number two matchups coming at 184. 2 versus 3 at 174. That's a hell of a match right there at 184. Defending national champ at 84, defending national champ at 174. Fireworks.
They're going to decide who's going to be the better one tonight. That's fun for everyone.
Who do they got weighed in at 197 there for two? I didn't see. But. All right. Flipping here. I tell you what, though, you look at both sides, and this is a heated rivalry now that Coach Miller is here on the Laura Stuhawk side. But, I think there's a lot of mutual respect between athletes. It's going to get chippy, but at the end of the day, I think these guys both know this is an amazing meet.
If it's not chippy, then why are you wrestling? You know what I mean? Like, this is a duel that definitely needs to be chippy, needs to be loud. If you're not being chippy, I don't think you're doing your job for a duel like this.
Well, we definitely don't need a limestone incident, though.
Oh, I mean, naturally, but.
All right, here we go. Get ready for some fun here, guys. Again, thank you, everybody, for tuning in throughout the year. We do this for you guys. And a little bit for us. We love it, too. All right, Warburg brings out Brady Kiner.
Graduate senior, Southeast Warren High School. For the Dewhawks, we got Jared Hensley, Lenox, Iowa, by way of Upper Iowa University, NWCA All-American last year.
Yep, both these guys were, I believe. All right, right off the bat, like I said, Worm, we got to get off to a fast start here and flip the tables early. Hensley likes to get off to a fast start.
He's got a really nice go behind. If you're not careful with your shots, all of a sudden you're going to get met with one.
Kiner with a nice shot. Now he's got us in the front head. Hensley's able to kind of square up here.
Hensley doing a good job squaring up, though. He needs to start peeling off that hand off the chin. But Kiner's doing a really good job shutting that out.
He's got it tight. Nothing yet.
Nothing yet. Great wrestling here.
Still wrestling on the edge. Kiner with like a dump over. Hensley's got that bottom hand, though. Nothing there.
Nothing there. Kiner's going to try his best to keep that toe in.
Hensley's doing a great job fighting this off. Stalemate. All right. That's a great scramble for Hensley. He gave up some tough positions there, but was able to fight it off well.
Hensley needs to keep his pace for 7 minutes.
Nothing yet, still.
Kiner did a really good job of the re-attack there.
It's going to be tough. It's going to be tough here. Oh, two takedown for Kiner. Hensley just got his arm trapped there. He's almost able to get back around. Now we're in trouble here, though.
Minute 30 left here in the first.
The roll through. Uh-oh. Fight it. Hold on here. Hold on here. We might have with two. Four back.
Reversal.
That was big time. That was big time there. He's just got to relax here. He can't let the moment get the best of him. Kind of reload here. Big breath. All right. 6-2 lead for Kiner. He's got 30 seconds of riding time here in the first period. Still a minute and 15 left to go on the clock.
He needs to get off to the side to do a decent return here. Kiner doing a really good job stepping in, gets the one.
7-2 Kiner now.
That 4-point near fall, you give up that 4-point near fall, all of a sudden you find yourself in a hole that you got to start working real hard out of.
Mm-hmm. All right, both guys squared up here in the middle.
Under a minute here left in the first.
Snap and go, snap and go. Nice pick there by Kiner. Hensley does a great job fighting it off here. Now he goes. All right.
30 seconds here.
Like to see us here end the period on top. Let's go out and get a takedown. But we'll find out who won the flip here. Worm, I didn't see. Good action by both wrestlers. Kiner's a little bit more aggressive so far, but Hensley certainly fought off quite a few attacks. Kiner's got position.
Kiner answers that ankle pick there.
Zero
right at the end period.
That's not ideal. That's not ideal there at the end of the period. Looks like it was Warburg's choice, so they deferred, and we're going to go down. All right, right off the bat here, we need to get out. Can't allow him to flatten us out and try to go for that bar again.
Hensley doing a really good job of stand up, controls the hands there, into a wizard.
Now they got the count. Nothing there. He came up to the body, yep. So.
He wants continuous motion. The ref gives continuous motion there.
All right, kiddo. All right, we got 34 seconds to riding time here right now for Brady Kiner. Kiner, alum of Southeast Warren High School, where Brandon Bauer, one of our former teammates, went as well. And Coach Rich there for a little while.
Kiner, I believe, was two-time state finalist for them. Going to that, back to that well on that tilt, trap arm tilt. Stalls counting.
Oh, Hensley's looking. Hensley again was looking for, trying to trap him on his back there, almost a defensive fall. But I mean, tough. We're giving up four here to another four, 13-2. Kiner just keeps on going back to the well, like you said. Now he's going in for a roll through.
This next one's most likely gonna be attacked if he gets the four count. That's tech ball.
There it is. Oh, Kiner came out right off the bat. Went for it. I mean, he was the aggressor the whole time, and he got to his stuff on top. That puts us in a hole. That's the kind of stuff we didn't need to have happen tonight. But you know what? Nine more matches left, so. Brady Kiner, Warburg with the tech ball here. Gives our crowd a little bit of a little thumbs down, but all right. Now we got to get right back after it here. Another tough customer for Warburg as they got the Dubuque native Joe Pins. And for the Dewhawks,
we got Aiden Evans.
Bettendorf. Joe Pins is another very well-rounded wrestler. He's got a lot of top game, good game on his feet here. So Aiden's got to get out to a start on Joe, though, because Joe's got a motor. So got to win the scrambles, got to win the positions here.
Evans looking for a 2-on-1 there. Pins counter on the inside of that. Aiden
nice
in
shot.
A shot.
Right away, Joe's going to look to roll around here a little bit. That was a nice shot, but you see Pins immediately dives to the ankle diving. So let's see here. Okay.
Going stalemate there.
Yeah, we got to keep that stuff up. Stay on his legs. Get him off yours. Nice snap down. Another nice shot.
Two shots to Joe Zero. I mean, there's still 7 minutes along this match, but Pins doing a really good job tying up the legs.
Nothing yet. We still got the leg underneath. Now we're coming back up, but we don't. Go ahead hunting here. Oh, we got two. A scramble possible. That should be Grady two. Possibly. Now Joe's getting his hit back around. Warburg crowd's calling for two on us. Evans has got that hip lock. I lost it again.
We should be getting to be two right here.
It's close here, Worm.
It should be two now, but
I can't see the other angle from where we're at. Saul has given nothing yet. I don't know if it's because we have that angle. Oh, we're still underneath it there. That's why. Now we step over. Danger roll.
He's got to get in position there.
Still wrestling here. This is the same position. He's going to stay underneath that foot. He's got it locked up. This is
about a minute and a half scramble here.
We'd like to get a stalemate here, and there it is, yep. All right, wowzers. That was great wrestling by both parties. Holy crap.
Still a minute left here in the first period.
Stay aggressive here, Aiden. Stay aggressive. Another shot.
That's the third shot.
Again, though, we gotta finish these, though. You know what I mean? Like, we gotta finish up. He ankle dives right away.
He shouldn't get passes just for being able to catch an ankle.
I get what you're saying here, but what I'm saying is we gotta get this finished. I think here comes another one. Yeah, there's Joe's shot. Now we gotta score. Okay. I think Joe was feeling the heat a little bit there. But three shots to none. Another dive.
That's another shot.
Okay. Roll through ankles. Watch the knee. Still nothing. Wow,
man.
This is a crazy match so far.
Great first period.
Come on, Aiden. There is, as Joe kind of steps back, that's where he wants to create the angle for his outside single.
Evans doing a really good job smothering there. 15 seconds left. Let's get out of this period scoreless.
I'm okay. Oh, boy. Joe kind of left his elbow up there. I thought we were going to be able to hit a duck. 2 seconds.
He's going to give no two there.
That is a good period for Aiden Evans. As we defer, Pinsey's going to take neutral. All right. Ooh, let's get back on our offense here, man. I'm telling you what, we're right there. Bad shot by Joe, really. He was able to get us down the front headlock. We got to move now. Right there, we missed an opportunity to get really aggressive. Joe kind of shot from way out, snap down, go behind there. That's what it called for. This is where we got to move. We got to move. Pins is good at making himself look busy on top. Already up to 30 seconds of riding time here.
Evans still trying to work up, though. Peel ankle.
Here we go.
Now he's got to explode up. Get his hips out.
There you go. Come on now. Move your feet, kiddo. Let's go.
Now we got push pace here. Now we got
another shot.
Another
here.
Shot.
Another ankle. Okay. Now, oh. Joe lost it here. Let's see if we can finish. Now we're in good shape. We left our ankle out again. Oh, sorry. We got to be able to finish that. Hopefully he gets to a double. It's almost like he's setting it up. Now we went the other side. There's the stalling call you've been waiting for, Worm. Not going much there.
Now we got that stall warning. It's really going to help.
Stay on him here, though. We got to stay on him. Another shot. He's able to get his hip back, though. This is a tough position for us. We got to be able to adjust here.
It's one thing taking a shot, but you got to take a shot where we're scoring. But, hey, we're also looking really busy.
23-7 on the clock here. Penn's got 43 seconds of riding time. Another shot for him. And see, there's the difference right there. His finishes are 2 out of 3 shots. He finishes, and we haven't been able to finish on 6 of ours. 10 seconds left to go. 4-1 lead for Joe Penn's. Our choice here in the third, so we got to keep creating action. I mean, at this point, we're going to go down. We've already got he's got the riding time, not locked up, but you can do this, Aiden. And what an amazing atmosphere here. This is nuts. These matches feel like they're going feels like it's been going on for 20 minutes. All right, Pins, like I said, is up over a minute of riding time. Evans has got to get a takedown. He's got to get out, takedown. I mean, we keep creating action. He's been warned and given up. He's been warned once. Minute and 42. Just kind of stay in the middle, but we got to explode up there. All right, here we go. He's starting to build a base. Pins brings us back down again. Come on, create the action.
We can't hope for a stall call on bottom.
Create the action here. Explode out. All right. So we got 55 seconds. Riding time's locked up. So effectively, it's a 5-1 lead for Joe Penn's. I'm actually kind of interested right now. They don't feel like going for the major here, or trying to even. So that says something. All right, we're working up here. 43 seconds. Just really can't get out. I mean, it's just really a pullback ride. We just got to explode out of our seat here. 27 seconds. We're flattened out.
Got to have a plan for your takedowns. I mean, that was a big thing. I mean, Evans took, you know, like we said, he took 6 shots to, yep, to Pins' 2-3.
Yep.
And, you know, we definitely probably wasted some energy there.
The conversion rate, though, you know what I mean? 66% to 0, you know what I mean? And, yeah, and he did create the action quite a bit, but Pins was able to finish when he needed to and finish with the ride out. So that's another win, though, for Wartburg to bring their lead to 8-0. Lots of lessons to be learned from that match here. Yeah, remember, these matches... There's more of these matches coming up here in the next couple weeks too, so it's important to take those losses and build on them in 2 and 3 weeks from now. So now here we go.
We got Bubba Shop, and I believe we got
Tarakina.
Yeah. Zyron Tarakina, yeah.
All right, Zyron comes from Hawaii, and Bubba Shop coming from Williamsburg. These two met earlier in the year up at Concordia. Was it with the Wartburg wrestler winning that match? So I think we've talked about this before. You know, Bubba's going to be really, really tough to beat, you know, if he's able to open up his offense on his feet.
If he can get on top and catch a good ride, I mean, it's a rough night. I mean, he's like gears a machine. He just gets tighter as he goes.
Bubba trying to dump here. Tarakina keeping us on the edge. Now he's got the 2-on-1. Be smart on the edge here. We got to wrestle on the edge. All right, he's able to clear the ties. Let's get to our ties here.
Tarakina in on a reshot. We're going out of bounds. Minute 55 here left here in the first. Still scoreless.
That's interesting. Just pick something up. We'll see if this factors in later. All right, Tarakina moving up and down here, bobbing around. Liking working out of that underhook. Like I said, last time in their matchup, he was just a better. He was better on his feet, you know.
Really nice misdirection outside single there. I'll give him props on that one. Bubba did a really good job kicking out of that. But it was really nice, really hard step right and then shift to the left.
Again here though, in this match it's a little different so far. Warburg's taking the center and he's moving us back. So we got to get on something. And there's nothing wrong with making this a two-period match, but at the same time, you know, we got to show something. We don't want to go in with a stall, so. It's going to be Warburg's choice. He's got a minute left to go here in the first.
I'm assuming there's probably going to be a warning.
Yeah,
coming
he's taking
here.
A lot of the mat. He's taking a lot of the mat. There it is. It's going to be, yep.
Hard. Oh. Oh, he did give a stall call here.
That was kind of an easy one there. I mean, I think he was going to call it anyway, and then the back out probably made it easier. But, all right, here we go. 48 seconds. Another shot.
Tarakina doing a really good job with his head fakes.
He's really kind of beating us around. I'd like to see something here from Bubba as far as like maybe breaking it and getting to a low single or a double.
Gonna go hard wizard here.
Stepped out of bounds. We got that. I don't like that. The short side of the mat there on both sides. All right, 9 seconds here, Worm, as we're going to go in the second period here. We have been warned for stalling. Tarakina's definitely been the aggressor in this first period, so we got to turn it up now.
But we're going to choose down here to start the second.
And this is where it starts here, really creating action, scrambles, you know. I know Warburg's probably thinking, like, you know, give one, not two. I know it's easy to say, but with a guy who likes to create scrambles. All right, he's able to turn in. Kind of just a side ride. And double up to his feet. And Warper kind of like catches the ankle there. We got to do this in the middle. We got to do this in the middle. We got to move in the middle. Create the action. We got to get something to get this crowd back into it here on the R side. But see, he does a nice job of just keeping that side and then hooking that ankle and then bringing them down. But there we go.
Try coming up again. 2-3 moves. Tarakina with their mat return.
Yeah, that was a good mat return there. So just kind of hanging on the side there, but it's smart. It's smart wrestling. We just got to build ourselves up on that side, that he's twisting the ankle on. And he's up to right now. It's a minute of riding time with a minute left to go here in the period. So it's going to open up doors for them as they get their choice in the third. Edge of the mat.
30 seconds left here in the second.
We have to get one, wouldn't you say, Worm? I mean,
yep.
We got to get one here. Tarakina is either tired or he just has that walk. Like one of the two, and I don't know. As he's walking back to the middle, it's kind of like he could just be that relaxed, I suppose. As he hops to the side again, chopping arms as we continue to work our way up here. Just hammers on that right side. A All right, 18 seconds. I mean, at this point, we need it. I mean, that's just a good. I mean, what are you supposed to say about that? It is just
a real tough ride.
Yep.
I mean, Joe Pins did the same thing. Real tough claw ride. And just sat deep with it.
You stay busy.
Yeah.
You know, you're not doing much, but it's enough, right?
So, Cerquito's want to go on his feet, too.
Yep, so we have to get a takedown here. I mean, at this point, we need to open it up. It's 0-0. He's got 2 minutes of riding time. Come on. Fakes. And again, you know, he's still taking. Now, we got time. It's a time waster here with that underhook. Even if he doesn't take out, we got to clear. You know, there's
Bubba
five,
needs to get to work.
Seconds. There's a shot. He's looking for there. Yep. He's able to measure it now, but look at, I mean, at this point, let's go. Got a minute and 20. Nice snap. Create action. Come on. One minute. You got to remember, he hasn't been warned. We've been warned. Like, all the cards are in his favor. We need a takedown. A shot from really long.
Whoa! Big toss. Big toss to the two. Terakita's going to be sitting tight. They're going to want stalling, of course, now.
Bring him down to the mat. Wrestle it here.
Cars one stalling, of course. 30 seconds left here. Here's that spark we were talking about. Here's that spark we needed.
Good. It's going to be right off the whistle.
Sits him back, but Terakita's turning into it.
Nothing yet. There's going to be a reversal. Stop the riding time. Nothing. Oh, that's the match. Gotta go get him, Bubba. That's about the worst thing that could happen. You gotta shoot off the whistle. Let's go. He thought it was a tie match. He didn't understand the match situation.
Hang on.
Did they call the stall? Yeah, they called the
stall. I didn't see him call a stall.
He did. He stopped the riding time. So it's going to be 2-2, and then the riding time is going to be 3-2. Warburg. We had the clock wrong here. You know what I mean? Like, it should have been 1, and then the escape. The final is 3-2. Not 4-2, it's 3-2. There it is. That's all right. We got to build on that again, too. I mean, those are just the match situations we got to win. All right, here it is. Now it's 11-0 for Warburg as they get out to a fast start. We got Daniel Reeves. From California, he's taking on Christian Rump. Got to stay on Rump, man. He likes to.
Danny's been known to ruin a Warburg party or two, so hopefully this is that one of those matches too. Rump does a really good job right off the gate, though. Rump's been been at Warburg for about 5 years in about 5 different weight classes.
That was a good takedown there, but Ruiz fought it off pretty well. You got to be careful, man. You know, Rick's not able. This is why I'm saying, like, two refs need to be in these high duels. Rump grabs the headgear there as he's going around. I mean, it's just things that you can't see, but having a second ref, you know, that helps out. I mean, it's smart by him if he's going to get away with it for sure. So
2-1 here, 2 minutes left here in the first.
I don't know if these two particularly have met. I know that Daniel Meeker and Rumpf had a great match up at Concordia earlier this year. But yeah, I mean, there's a lot to be said. He's an extremely explosive wrestler. But Danny's a veteran, man. I mean, he's been around the block a long time, so he's got his own tricks too. So kind of have to weather storm sometimes. But we also have to be aggressive too. Crowd's into it. Let's go, Danny. Got a minute and 15 seconds. Rumpf's only got the three seconds of riding time. All right, both wrestlers in the center. Minute to go here in the first. 2-1. Christian Rumpf's been around the circuit a little bit. I think he was at Augsburg for a couple weeks, and then he ended up at Wartburg. Danny is a Army guy, and then he did some junior college out in California before he came to Loras. A two-time All-American. All right, 33 seconds here. This is where you got to look for Rumpf to get fired up with a zero-time score. So we need to get on our offense here.
That's the thing about Rumpf. He can score at zero time. Like he's really explosive and he does a really good job of he'll be dropped down to his knees and then shoot a double out of that position. So you got to be hands out in front the entire time.
All right, here we go. 8 seconds left. Shot. See, he measured that. But give us credit here for getting aggressive at the end of the period. All right, we defer. And they're going down. Really, just that one takedown in the beginning of the first, 2-1 for Rump. As he's taking the down position. Caution on top man.
No, it should be caution
on
bottom.
That's what I meant. I don't
know. He was trying to tattle there, but you can't move.
It's kind of a different start there, too, but Rump's kind of balled up. Now he gets to his feet.
Danny's jumped to the side. Big mat return would be nice here. You're going to give up one, but Danny.
Oh! Run forward. You felt that, too, huh?
I felt it.
So 3-1. Here's they both locked in the same position. Quick escape for Rump. 9 seconds of riding time for Ruiz. All right. Both guys in the middle. Got to be careful here that he doesn't try to measure our shot. Here we go. That's tough. Physical. Look at this. You see what he's doing here?
Yeah, he's pressing.
not a bad strategy at all. That was interesting, for sure. Now we got the headgear off.
What is the rule on headgear? Is it just like...
It's not like shoes. It's just nothing. Just fix it and go. All right, minute and three. Like I said, still 3-1 for Rumpf. I'd like to see Ruiz get back in that... Yes, get back in there and get physical here.
Get your face dirty here.
Work the head.
You're not. Long distance shots with Rumpf is not going to be not the gameplay you want to play. You're going to have to get right up in his face and get bang with him.
Yep. All right, 37 seconds. Both guys down to their feet, down to their knees here. Now back up, ear to ear. The Rump does just a good job there. He's holding our wrist. Man, a takedown here at the end would be huge for us. Rump takes a shot. Now we get to where we need to get to. Wow, they're banging in there, man. Good job by both guys. All right. Good period here. All right.
All right, big period here.
All right, so here we go. Third period, 3-1 lead for Christian Rump. 9 seconds of riding time for Ruiz. He just pulls us right underneath. He's still got that, still has that lock. Saul could have kept caught in there realistically, but that's an escape.
Now we're in the ball game here. Both guys both seem to have full tank gas on them, so.
Yeah, it's just been, I mean, a moment of snap down, go behind for Rump in the first and a lot of hand fighting in the middle. I mean, other than that, it's been just a grind. Minute and 13 seconds, so, I mean, we're going to have to get on some sort of offense here. And I'd rather not wait until we get down to 30 seconds, so.
Right.
That's a shot there. We're staying in good position, but, I mean, we have to score, so.
Yeah. Rump can do this all night. We actually have to start taking shots.
Seconds. No stall calls on either side, so I don't know.
We can't wrestle in this hand fight game. We gotta create some action.
Seconds. Yeah, that's trouble.
Danny's staying right in the fight though.
It's just, you just can't wait until 10 seconds, kiddo. Ugh. All right, another decision here for Warburg. Four straight matches, gonna be 14-0. Got to turn the tide. It's got to be now.
And the 157 match for Warburg, David Hollinsworth.
All right. Another, it should be another great match here. As we got, for Loris, we got Zeke Smith taking on David Hollinsworth. Hollinsworth, NWCA national champ last year. Zeke Smith, an All-American at 149. So these guys are at 157. You know, Zeke's got some family all over. He's got a lot of family, but he's got family all over the place watching from different locations. You know, he's got Loris blood in him. He's got some, I know one of his uncles, national champ at Warburg. So he's got it all going on. His cousin wrestled at Warburg. So his brother wrestled for Loris. So...
His brother coaches at Platteville. I mean, they're everywhere.
Yep. So.
What's up, Eddie Smith?
Zeke's looking to control the action. I like this start. This is one of the better starts we've had since Aiden Evans was wrestling. As far as.
We're looking like we're doing the work right now. But Hansworth's doing a really good job of controlling that front head. Even though Zeke's pushing him around, all it takes is a real quick snap, it looks like. Like, it's not afraid, Hollinsworth's not afraid to just let him have that arm. But Zeke's not going to let a fight get out of hand.
Oh, that's good. That's good. That's where he wants to be. We want to be in on him. We want to be on his head. We want to be front headlocks and two-on-ones for sure. Don't want to be given too much space, so... Zeke's coming off a pretty big win against Henderson from Coe a couple weeks ago.
Doing a really good job digging that 2-on-1, but Hans was just doing a really good job of keeping the front head.
Mm-hmm.
You can't really fault any guy really at this point besides maybe back pressuring in him from Hollingsworth.
Right. Continue to push forward here. All right. I'm going to create.
Minute here.
Fake shot.
First.
Yes, nice.
Good
very
hand
good.
Fighting here.
Very good, Zeke. But see, none of it really, you can tell Hollingsworth, you know, he's been around the block, man. None of the stuff really bothers him as far as, you know, the fakes and everything. He's kind of just staying in good position so far. And
you can definitely tell there's a size differential, too.
Oh, nice little boot scoot there. It's 2 points. Looks like they're calling two. What's the difference on that? Why is that not a count there? I guess I'm confused on that, but is it because he's still sitting on his butt?
I think he's sitting on his butt, and he's pressuring in. He's pressuring into the hands. So really, it is kind of a stalemate in the sense of he can't work up, and Z can't really work out of it.
Well, that quick takedown there. Now we got 27 seconds left. We've got to create the action here, and we got to get one. Zeke right up to his feet. Hollingsworth brings him back down right away back into the sit. Zeke's looking nice.
Get our one here. We got our one.
Get our head out there. Walk him off.
Walk him off.
Walk him off.
There's got to be a ding. There's got to be a ding.
There it is.
There's one.
That's early, too. That's a big sequence right there. Zeke, get ready here on the whistle. Get ready on the whistle. That is a big sequence of events.
That's a pace pusher there. Yep. There's a warning one. Used to be.
What was that? Snap, hard snap?
No, hands to the face.
Okay.
So there was his warning.
There it is again.
Another reshot there.
Okay, see, so now he's feeling us because when we come in for our to cuff the head, that's the second boot scoot that he hit. So, I mean, now we got to be able to adjust here in the second period. And we're going to be down. Looks like Warburg's got 16 seconds of riding time. One thing Zeke does have to be careful of when he turns in is he's got to be careful of the cradle.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, he's pretty smart on it and really strong in that position. So watch him as he turns in here. Yep. As I said it, get those hands. You got a hand fight here. It's going to be tough to take him back, I think. But, okay, good. He was able to get it out.
Going again for it, but Zeke's just got to keep moving.
Really here, though, I mean, even he's got to bring us back. No, don't put ourselves on our back. But wow, he was able to get to a leg there and not put himself in danger where he's giving up points. Oh, if he can get that head, if he can pull that in and get that head. Tough hips right now from Hollingsworth. Tough hips.
Zeke's doing a good job, though. He's going to get his one, but we just get... There's only 7 seconds of riding time there.
Yeah, we got a minute and 13 seconds of riding time for Warburg. It's 2-2 effectively. He's been warned. Let's see if we can get another walk-off here.
I was going to say, I'd be trying to shoot him off
the
mat.
Yeah, but you got to be smart. This guy is a smart wrestler, man. You know what I mean? When he sizes us up there, you can just tell on those boot scoots that he was waiting for that. But at the same time, keep pushing it. Yes, looks good. Zeke's keeping out of the face, staying on the side of the head. Oh, he measured that. Now let's see if we can get to our front head here and go behind. 23 seconds.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Back to our feet, come on. Let's wrestle smart here.
He
wrestle smart
it.
Here.
He hopped to it. Stay there. Nothing yet. Nothing yet. Don't give it up, kiddo.
There's two. 3 points.
He was waiting for that go behind. Smart wrestling right now from Hollingsworth. Taking our aggression, and he scored on it twice now. Our aggression with the snaps, and then our aggression again with the go behind. what's the common denominator? You left your elbow up a little bit, right? Mm-hmm. So, all right. So they're going to take neutral. Smart play. Seat's working. I feel like we could just turn the table if we could just get one. Right to the reshot. Two more. Dude, it's all counters. All right, here we go. So, riding time here, a minute and 42 seconds. We need takedown, ride out, takedown some back points. There it was. Scoot, scoot, scoot. See, and then he scoots, and then right to the double. Two more.
He is very good at counter wrestling here.
Warburg wants him to let him go and get another takedown. All right, Zeke, we need to know our situation. It's 8-4, 9-4 with riding time. He'd need two more takedowns, right, Worm?
Yeah.
Am I looking at something different?
He'd need two more.
All right, look. Now another shot. Another shot here by Hollingsworth.
That was slick, but nothing at the time.
All right, another decision, 9-4 for Warburg. He's going to bring it to 17-0. Now we're up to 165 pounds. Worm, we got to start making some stuff happen quick. As Warford takes the first five. We got to turn the tables. We got to get some pins. We got to do something here. We want to get back in this duel. So far, it seems like they've just been one step ahead of us along the way. You know what I mean? Like, we've wrestled some really good matches, and we've just been one step behind. That was awfully strange. That was a great shot by Pfizer, but it was like, I don't know. Doyle just didn't react. Like, he almost wanted them to get. All right, come on, Gaby. Finish this, kiddo. So Gabe Pfizer from Grundy, Virginia. Four-time state champ out there.
Elevate it. Now with the party start.
Finish it strong. Nothing yet.
Yeah, take it outside. Yeah, take your body outside. You're not going to get in a whole lot of scoring position here. You need a bump. Set him outside. Set that foot on the inside of his leg.
Blast it. Yes. Get between the legs. Between the legs. There you go.
That was a big takedown.
Guys going right into the legs. Flatten him out. Wow.
That's a big fire starter there. That just kind of woke up everyone again.
That was an aggressive showing there, where he popped the legs in and just flattened Doyle out. Am I right? That is Doyle, right?
I believe
Independence
so.
Independence kid, yep. So I believe so. They had Doble and Doyle both lined up here. But they got him flattened out here. Not much he can do, but we can build some riding time here. Stalemate there for Rick Stahl, called stalemate. I'm not a fan because we were gaining riding time, but. All right, right off the whistle here. all these matches, so crucial for regional seedings and whatnot. But again, I'll just keep stressing this on both sides. It's like, how are we going to build to get better, you know, and for 2 weeks from now?
Pfizer's got that wrist trapped. He's going for the tricep, trying to do that sit back tilt. He's get off the side. Nice return. I know everyone's been obsessed with the Shane Sparks big mat return thing, but really all you got to do is get that your opponent enough where he's got his weight transferred just enough to get him to feel a little bit light, and you can return from any position. Doesn't always have to be big.
Right. All right. Up over a minute now for riding time. Good. Gabe is smart there. Let's see if he can get another takedown. You know what? Last week at UD, he really got fired up in the third period and was able to get a tech fall. He really dug deep to get that on a wrestler that really wasn't competing, but, you know, kind of hanging on. And this is what we need here. We need some scoring, and we need a lot of it. You know, this deep into the season, too, it's like it's an interesting point. Like, where are they going to be at here in a couple of weeks? Is this going to be their guy? Do they have some other guy that maybe just popped up on their lineup sheet? You know, I don't know. He might be on there. We'll see. But
as long as this paperwork's done, that's all we ask.
Nice snap down there by Pfizer.
Well, Pfizer needs to start getting to work. It's nice to have that real big takedown and the real big leg ride, but we're just going to sit here in this underhook for 35, 40 seconds, and then we definitely got to get moving.
Nah, don't hang there. You don't want to hang there. Come on. Elbow deep here. Let's go. Quick score. All right. 2-1 here. We got a minute and 15 seconds. It's our choice. TJ and the rest of the coaches are saying, let's go down. Let's get that escape. Let's start to build a lead. Smart wrestling here.
I do believe this is Doble.
Okay. Oh, it is Doble. Okay. I apologize for that. Ow. That was nice to get. He was able to get his hips out and get one. Let's score here. Come on, kiddo. You got the position you want. Get to your high crotch here. Snap and go. Good job. Watch this now. Watch out for a shot here. In space now. Bring him down. All right, 3-1. We still have that riding time. Thanks to a quick escape. Nice shot. Doble was able to square up. Heavy, heavy hands here. My guess is
big snap, big score. That's what we need.
My guess is he probably learned some heavy hands from his old man back in the day.
I apologize. It is Doyle. former Warburg Knight and former Waller Catholic wrestler Connor Dean just informed me of that.
Thank you, Connor. Another snap. We got to open it up here. Come on, bud. I just feel like if Gabe should trust that high crotch.
Oh, just fire it.
I mean, I'm telling you, he gets to it, and the finish rate is unbelievable. He's just got to trust that he can get to that position, which he can. We know he can here. Fire it off. There we go. That's going to be a stall. Yep, there we go.
Ding.
All right, come on, kiddo. Let's go. Now we got to start building our lead here. Nine seconds left. The thing we don't want right now is we don't want this to come down to a takedown. So let's get some riding time here. Wear them out.
Big scoop.
I think he likes to get that claw, you know, so try to get in the Turk position, obviously, overall.
And hit, you can go try going with a big return left.
Minute and 14 second of riding time right now. And they continue to build this. Will's able to get up to his feet. All right, minute and 26 seconds of riding time here. 3-2 lead. Nice shot by Iser. Let's see if he can finish it with a track start here. He's strong there. Yes. Look
Come
at
up with it. We let go of it.
I'm surprised he didn't go to stay on. I'm surprised he didn't try to stay on that, but anyhow, it's still getting to the offense. Minute and 18 seconds. 3-2. This is huge coming in these next three matches. We got to get this W. Shot by Doyle. Get your hips down. There you go. Get them down. Fifty-one seconds left. Circle, circle, circle. That's going to be one on us. He kind of just ran at us with the underhook, but it's a good, smart move on the edge of the mat.
Yep.
All right, come on, Gabe. Finish this. 44 seconds left. Both wrestlers have been warned. Another shot here, nothing going. 26 seconds, so we got riding time locked up. 4-2 lead. I'd like to see us finish on top here, but we're presenting well in the middle. A little half shot by Doyle. 12 seconds. Another shot. Short offense here. Short offense here. 5. All right. That was 2-point takedown there at the end, but
I agree, but
that's all right. 1 point. We're going to finish with a 4-2 lead, a 4-2 win. Finally getting on the board here in match number 6. As we got the next two matches, our marquee matchups for us tonight. We got Zane Mulder for Wartburg taking on one of our seniors. Jacob Krakow. This is a huge match. This guy's definitely been one of my favorites since he walked on campus. Mulder, like I said, I think he might be 16-17-0 here. Ranked number 2 right now at 174. And like I said, in some polls they have us at 3 or 5. But let's hope for a grinder here. A typical Krakow match is a grind every time.
If you want a hand fight with Krakow, you might as well just do it at Nebraska. I mean, the guy's just, he's got bricks for hands, he's got a forehead made of stone. It's just a long night if you decide you want to play this game with him.
All right, as we go under 2 minutes now.
Mulder, though, I believe is a sophomore out of Dallas Center Grimes.
Mm-hmm.
Wrestled at Iowa State for a brief stint and then came to Wartburg.
Yep, he was in the lineup last year. He was All-American. I think he might have got second.
Nice. Crack out outside shot. At least keeping yourself busy.
And I'll tell you what, I'm so used to Jacob just, you know, scoring on single legs and that stuff, but he's got a lot more in the bag. Like I said, he's a veteran.
Mulder in on a shot. Great job stuffing the head there. Brings it right back to our feet. You know, like I said, the thing about Krakow is just very workmanlike. You know, just one of those guys that you're going to have to work real hard for. Mulder in on a real nice high crotch. Krakow in with the rodeo.
Want to get to the crossface here, huh? Deep hip, but Mulder's building up. Now he's got to the double.
There's two.
Forward, get forward, get forward, get forward. Mulder did a good job there of getting to the double leg when he stopped. He's able to wrap around both legs and then finish. All right. So 37 seconds left to go here. One escape would be ideal here as the period moves. Breakout building up, looking to get that claw off. I was looking for a shin toss. Great job. That's
2-1. 24 seconds riding time. 23 seconds left here in the first.
You know what? If this kid wants to be a coach someday, he's going to be a hell of one, because that is a perfect stand-up technique. Nice throw-by shot.
What we got here? Well, it's called. Oh, we got a forward move.
It's okay. Uh-oh. What are we doing here? Keller, what are you doing here?
Got to make sure the ring's back.
All right, let's go. It's tough wrestling. It's tough wrestling. I get it, dude. All right, 10 seconds left to go here.
Coach Keller really passionate about coaching. A guy could argue a freaking if a guy's shoes are blue.
All right, Mulder's going to go down here. 2-1 in favor of Mulder. He's got 24 seconds of riding time. Tough ride on the side. Mulder looking to build his base. He's able to come up. Krakow brings him back down.
Mulder though back.
That was a nice. That was certainly a nice. When he came down, he went right to that switch action. Smart switch action, but great job by Krakow for being ready for that and only giving up the one there. So he got it down to 9 seconds of riding time. 3-1 lead here for Mulder. Nice snap by Krakow.
We got to create some action.
I don't know how he can see with all that hair in his eyes. That's unbelievable. I guess that's the way the kids do it these days, right? Nice snap again by Krakow.
How old are you?
Getting older every day, Worm.
I understand the Super Bowl halftime show is going to be more up your alley with it. But come on, man. Got to stay a little bit hip.
Snappy, snappy, snappy. All right, here we go. 50 seconds left to go here in the second. Still a 3-1 lead here for Mulder.
45 here.
Another snap. These are some hard snaps. But really not phasing Mulder too much. All right. Now we're getting to our underhook. Getting to two double unders. Nothing going. 14 seconds. And Mulder is down at 165 last year, too. So he's up a weight. Krakow's been at 74 since he's been here. He's a 3-time All-American. All right, zero time. Going into the last period. 3-2.
Real important period here for Loris.
All right, another start, another good start here as Krakow comes inside. Mulder looking to get some riding time. I see his dad Zach down here in the crowd coming in from Des Moines area. Like I said, it's a big, big match for both these wrestlers. Minute 46. He's able to turn in. Good action here. Kind of leeching. Mulder's able to leech on. Good technique by him, able to keep it close and get us out of bounds. 33 seconds of riding time. Kind of wearing on us a little bit here, but Jacob's got this one. He's got it.
Minute 30 here. Muller going to drop down to that leg. 2, 3, 4.
No, and then he released it. Smart move by Mulder. That should be
one.
No riding time. Oh,
nice outside shot. Got it. Yeah, score here. Got to score here, Jacob.
Oh, that's good. That's good action. You know what? That was really good action. He felt that. You know what I mean? I'd be looking for him to go towards that again, that carry action. So here's the table. It's 1 minute and 10 seconds left to go. 3-2. No riding time. Takedown here is huge. Mulder in on a shot now. Smart shot. We're getting our hips away. Fighting it, and he's going to try to look to go to a double. Now nothing there. Now we're going for double unders. All right, 47 seconds left. These guys are warriors, man. These guys have been banging this whole match. Another shot here by Krakow. Muller's able to slow us down here on the front head. Now we're back up to our feet. He's able to circle us back. We want to be the other way. 27 seconds. Another shot, another outside single. Muller's doing a good job of keeping our right hand in the pocket. 14 seconds. Krakow's got to get out of that front head. 10 seconds. 6 seconds. We got time. Stall calls. Not going to do anything. Not going to do anything. Mutual respect here for the opponents in the middle of the mat. That's going to bring it to 20-3. That's a hell of a match for both wrestlers there. Again, they'll be seeing a lot more of each other this year. So, all right, here it is. The marquee matchup of the night. We got number one ranked national champ, Kyle Briggs, versus number two ranked national champ, Shane Legal. All I can say here, man, is weather the storm. Weather the storm.
I've been around Kyle Briggs since he was a freshman in high school, and the one thing that he has is a machine gun pace. He goes and goes and goes. He will shoot until he literally can't shoot no more. So that is exactly right, Joe. You got to weather the storm with him because he's going to come at you for 7 full minutes, and it's going to be a heavy, heavy pace.
Man, I look at some of these matches, Merv, and I start to think about regionals already, and it's like, you know, it's already kind of BS, the regional that we have, by far the toughest regional. We leave guys home that should be that are top five guys in every weight class because of the way the NCAA feels that it needs to be set up, which is complete trash. But I'll tell you right now.
Disclaimer, we do support the NCAA in all athletic competitions.
But I tell you, there's going to be some battles here in a couple weeks. Briggs in on a shot. Shane's able to get to a roll through. Briggs able to get to a crossface now. He's trying to run it to a cradle. No, I mean, NCAA isn't trash. Just the way they run the autumn. There's no, you know, the way they run the bidding for Division III. But you need like 400 teams, and you qualify 18 guys. That sounds good. All right. So Briggs with the takedown. Kind of riding us. We need to get to our feet here and start to create some action. Riding our right side. 30 seconds left. But Worm, there's not a single coach in our region that wouldn't agree with what I just said.
Oh, so. No, I'm not trying to argue. I was just trying to get a good laugh out of that one. But no, I totally understand. I mean, you look at 133 pounds. You got four or five of the guys ranked in the top 10. You know, and only three of them go.
The other thing is our region travels all over the country to wrestle the best competition. All right, 40 seconds of riding time here for Briggs as Shane gets to his feet. See, Briggs does a good job. He's able to trap that leg. Shane's trying to hit that hit a switch action.
Speaking of regionals, tickets are on sale now at www.fiveflagcenter.com. Get your tickets right now so that way you guys can be able to watch regionals Friday, February 24th and 25th, I do believe, at Five Flag Center.
All right, Briggs is able to put a good ride on us here. Up to a minute and 20 seconds of riding time. As we go out of bounds again, 44 seconds left to go here. Another attempt to try to, so he like traps, like trap a leg. There's a setback. Uh-oh. Let's go see if we can get some here. This is a weird position. That was strange. We weren't able to get through that. I thought maybe we'd be able to get our hips out and then get that back down, but Greg's looking for a, still kind of riding the ankle. I mean,
almost 2 minutes of riding time here.
Yep. There's no doubt about it, man. He's been ahead of us every step of the way. So 6 seconds left. Let's see if there's a little magic here. Love to see one. Love to see one here. All right, that period. Grace gets a takedown. Rides us for the rest of the period. No answer, so 2 minutes and 10 seconds of riding time. All right, we find ourselves in a tough match against, like I said, number one versus number two. We got to figure something out here. Up to his feet. So he's trying to clear his, see how he tries to clear that right ankle, and Briggs is on it every time. He's trying to clear that ankle and hit a step back, but it's just smart wrestling.
Doing a really good job of controlling Shane's hips. And I mean, you said it, like, it's kind of weird not seeing Shane like scoring enough points right
now. Here we go.
This guy's got his number tonight, and Shane's ready to fight for it.
Yeah, well, it's a 7 minute match, so here we go. But like I said, that's just they've got that step back kind of figured out a little bit, and then, you know, like I said, these are where the adjustments are made now. Now what can we do? Can we get a score? Briggs in on another shot. What can we do here? Just right around the corner.
I tell you, he shoots at, like I said, he shoots at a machine gun pace, and you know, he just, when he gets on a leg, he latches on tight and he runs it.
All right, 1 minute here in the second. Left in the second. 4-1 lead. He's going to have riding time locked up here pretty soon, too. All right, come on, Shane. Get one here. All right, he gets one here. Briggs is right back after us. We got to create the – there we go. We're moving him now. But we got to protect ourselves, too. Start to time the shots. But this is – I tell you, this is – Four to two. We said 26 seconds left. Two takedown. Six to two. Good fight there. Come on. One step ahead of us again here. All right. It's going to be. What do we got going on here? We got a little blood, I think. So, scenario here. It's 6-2. 2 minutes left here. Starting the third period. Riding time's locked up. So, about all I can say is We gotta see. I don't think he's made a decision yet. My guess is he's probably going down, but maybe not. Maybe he'll go on his feet and look to try to major. But either way, we got to figure something out. And again, at this point in the match, like, we're gonna make a comeback here. But if you don't, you've got to be able to feel something. You've got to be able to pick something up for the next time you wrestle. This is the second time these guys have wrestled. It's been a year and a half, whatever, since the last time. But it's just, even if it's just one small thing. Like, right now, Briggs has made the adjustments, and now Shane's got to figure out how to make the adjustments for the next match and the match after that. So, claw ride. Just night into a nice Granby, and that's a reversal. 8-2. Like I said, just one step ahead. Looks like they got a lot of sweat on the mat here. They're going to clean that up. So 8-2. 9-2 riding time. We're going to need something spectacular here, but I'm not going to say it can't happen. All right, Shane up to his feet here. Makes it 8-3. Moving good. Nice snaps. Let's see if we can get a takedown here. Feel it here, bud. Nice
takedown.
That was beautiful. This is what I'm talking about.
Now Shane's going to go up on top, and we'll see what we can get done here.
All right, 8-5. Kind of just give us a stalemate here, Rick. You can't get our arm out. He's just holding it. Wow, it's calling stall on Briggs for just kind of trapping that arm there. I'll be interested to see here what Coach Miller does if they go out of bounds. I would have to believe he's going to want to go to his feet, but I don't know. All right, Shane hustles back. I don't know. Nope, they're gonna try to see what they can do on top here, I think. Maybe, I tell you what, a four-pointer would be nuts here. You've seen it happen not too long ago. All right, tough ride here, but Briggs is working up. Nice job, Shane, flattening him out. Dude, I love it. I love it. Just keep scooting, kiddo. Keep scooting. Reach back. There, see, he kind of holds it in because Shane wants to get that bar, and he just crunches it down. Okay, now he gets to the bar. Now he gets to the bar. He's got 12 seconds. He's got 12 seconds. He's got 10 seconds. He's going to have to run it hard. At this point, run it. It doesn't matter. He slips it out. But see, that's what I'm talking about, Worm, at the end. There's slight things that he felt at the end there. You know what I mean? Coming back a little bit. I'm telling you, that's what we need. That's exactly what we needed out of that match. Those two will be seeing a lot more of each other, too, this year. All right. 23-20 now. Or, sorry, 23-3 for the Wartburg Knights. As we're going into 197 pounds. Again, if you don't think these matches are important, every one of these matches is so important right now. Colin Murphy versus Colby Woods. Colby Woods been around for a long time.
Murphy, a senior junior out of California, San Diego area, I believe.
Yep.
Former wrestler for former Loras All-American Chris BZL.
Yeah, my coach. Murphy didn't walk out there, so I have to assume that his plan is to come back again next year. Same with Zeke Smith, I noticed earlier. All right, hanging up, tough on the head here. It's another one of them situations where, you know, Derek Van Tagger had a match with Woods earlier in the season and up at Concordia, and it was a crazy match. And that's where we got to be able to learn things here from that and see what Murphy was able to pick up. Woods is a game competitor for sure. Kind of sit in the pocket. Nope, that's not. See, this guy bleeds more than anybody I know.
Yeah, he does take a lot of blood time there.
I mean, I think he was bleeding literally before the match. I was watching him stick swabs up his nose. Like, you know those kids? There's tons of kids out there like that. You know what I mean? But it's just like one of those things, like you walk on the mat, bleed. It can affect a match both ways for either wrestler.
It slows the momentum down. Like, you know, you get a takedown and all of a sudden you're bleeding again. You gotta stop.
Oh, certainly. I'm just saying, like, it can affect a match on both sides. That's what I'm saying. That Van Tiger match up at Concordia, I think that match lasted like 25 minutes when you counted all the blood time and stoppages. It was just an absolute nuts match. All right, Woods is ready to go. He's back in.
Got to get his headgear.
Well, now his headgear is ready. All right. Now, Murphy, get refocused here as you get back in. 0-0, guys. A minute and 40 seconds. Head-to-head there a little bit. It'll be interesting how the next couple weeks pans out. I don't think either one of these lineups is set yet for regionals, so we'll see what happens. Minute and 19, we got blood stoppage again. You know where I'm, I guess, is we still got a match and a half left. I really think, you know, as we watched, but we came out, we wrestled tough in a lot of those matches, but there's just like I said, one or two things, we're just like one or two things away. You know, you look at 141 or you look at 133 where it just comes down to finishing shots, you know?
Yeah, and like I said earlier, momentum is a huge thing in this duel. You get on a roll and then all of a sudden, you know, it's a train.
Right. I'd love to see what at the end of that match there with Shane. He absolutely, I think, found something that he's going to go to later on in the season. There's booing because of the blood. I mean, like, again, there's like really nothing that can be done. It's
there's still blood time. I just got halfway through War and Peace.
Yeah, so. It's just like I said, it's one of those things, man. Like, I don't think Kobe Woods wants to be sitting on the side of the mat with bleeding. But this is where, too, Murphy's got to stay focused. You know what I mean? Stay focused. Don't be thinking too much. Just get to your offense. I'd anticipate neither wrestler will be tired by the end of this match if this continues, though. All right. Back to the center we go. 57 seconds left here in the first period. All right, both in the middle. Surprised to see Woods there. I was going to say, I haven't seen him take a shot. That's surprising to me. Oh, boy. Oh, again, like Worm was saying earlier, guys, get your tickets for regionals.
The 25th and 26th. I do apologize for that date correction.
Yep, and it is a Friday, Saturday this year. We're going away from the Saturday, Sunday bid that we had. It is going to be a Friday, Saturday this year. So it's good and unfortunate in some ways. Some people might not make it on Friday till the evening session, but that is our regional is. It's like a national tournament. I mean, it is. You have to wrestle 2 days of extremely good competition. just to qualify for the national tournament.
Yeah, I mean, every match is earned at this regional. I mean, like I said before, I mean, you got probably six of the top 10 teams in the country are going to be at this regional.
Yep. All right, Woods coming out now, firing a little bit. 34 seconds left to go. Love to see Murphy get a takedown. Woods with a shot. We want to get away from that. We want to get away from that. Woods is working his way up. And a blood stop. But see, Murphy did. See, I like what Murphy did there. Like, Woods kind of stopped because the blood was coming out. But keep going. Let Stahl make that call, you know?
How are we... There is no blood, run out. You can't run out of blood time, can you?
I don't think so. Anybody out there that knows that rule, you can send us a text. Getting back to it. 23 seconds left to go still in the first. Like I said, just unbelievable amount of blood going on today. Which
seconds in this first period. Still scoreless.
Interested to see what. There you go, Colin. Banner in the head here a little bit.
That's some good hand fighting there.
It's going to be Kobe Woods' choice to see what they decide to do. I think they're set to take him down. They're going to go down. So no score after that first period. Woods able to get up to his feet here. Gets the escape. Let's see if either wrestler can get some flow going before the next blood stoppage.
Well, luckily this period is a minute shorter than the first period.
Nice shot.
Takedown by Woods.
Gotta work up.
Murphy's not afraid to go headhunting.
No. I'd like to see him get reached back. If he's gonna do that, reach back and try to get to our a Wizard, but
he's not afraid to go big on the neck wrench.
No, absolutely not. Alright, so Woods with the takedown and he's going back to the side again. Oh boy.
Give a shout out to all alumni that are listening tonight. I'm assuming that probably there's a Steve DeWitt out there. There's definitely probably a Joe Wood. I know there's a Tegan Podliska. I mean, if anyone else wants to get a quick shout out in, you guys can text me. I'll give you guys a shout out, but thank you guys so much for tuning in.
Yeah, good luck, guys. I know we got a lot of our alums, our coaches. Good luck tomorrow with districts and regionals and Louisiana State tournaments going on, and John L's got a hell of a squad down there in Louisiana, one of our former coaches. The Patrons are checked in already, so. All right, so to run it down again, we're at a minute and 24 seconds. Woods was able to get an escape and a takedown here in the second period. Murphy's got to be out again. Like, notice that same ride. They coach that same ride. Almost every one of their wrestlers rides ankles like that, and they do it well. But there is ways to beat that, and we just got to figure it out.
Absolutely. One more important shout-out. I got a couple of shout-outs to former lower 125-pounder Matt Randoni and former, like I said before, a former shout-out to Eddie Smith at 165-pound All-American for the Blue Hawks as well, tuning in.
All right, Murphy up to his feet here. Woods grabs the ankle. Should be a count. Now a soft wrestling. Here we go. They want him to get after him. The coaches are freaking. They're saying, get after this guy. Stay on him. It's just tough to keep a pace for either wrestler, though, in this match. Shot from distance. Now we got to be able to go.
Got to get stretch his legs out here.
Okay, he's not quite. But it's going the opposite way. They're telling him to go wrap around. Reach back, and let's get that hand off. Boy, come on, Murph. Now Murph's got a cramp in his toe. We got blood time, so he's got time. He doesn't take injury. This is nuts. I'd like to see what Volga weighed in at here at heavyweight because... I think there was some, he might be moving around or possibly looking to challenge here in the next couple of weeks too. So I know he was working his way down, but he'll be giving him quite a bit of size at heavyweight tonight, as usual. I can't tell, Murphy's grabbing at his foot. I don't know if it's a cramp or if it's like, I don't know. He'll have to toughen it up. He's a tough kid. Three to one. 20 seconds left to go here in the second period.
Giving a shout out to Bryce Everson tuning in, former national qualifier for the Duhawks tuning in. He's got an MMA fight coming up here. He's currently 1-0 amateur, so kind of cool watching him fight.
All right, 6 seconds. That foot is really bothering Murphy, so interested to see what that's all about. 30 seconds here, like a riding time as we go down. Hand fighting underneath. All right, he's
Murphy's
able to
got
catch
a foot.
The foot.
And I just got to pressure that back in.
So Woods is kind of like going up there. This is a dangerous position here for Woods. If we can swim out.
Yeah.
Catch an arm. Okay, look to catch an arm. Woods is sitting in the crotch. Again, though, this isn't a – okay, now we hop over. We should be in a situation.
We
to
should
get
be back
points.
Back points. Think about back points here.
Nothing yet. No two given. Got to get between those legs. Still, okay. So the Woods is still on top here. But we were not in bad position there. How do we not finish that? Dang it, I thought we had him dead to rights too. And the nose starts flowing again. Murphy's grabbing at his ankle or his leg. Like I said, I can't tell if it's his foot, but. Dude, I tell you what, man. I scooted by there. It's like almost like Murphy just needed to cross the hips and run it forward.
Crowd's definitely starting to wake up.
Wake up might be the right word. All right, 1:06. One thing to note, Woods does have 1:26 of riding time. We get up to our feet. Murphy's essentially looking like he might be on one leg here, but 55 seconds left to go. Woods is going to be able to kind of time our shots here a little bit, I think.
45 seconds left here for Murphy. Murphy's got to push pace, got to get a takedown here. Starting to become a backwards track meet.
Nice attempt there. Woods able to, that's like, again, like great to have this in the first period, but there's just the pace, is just, there was no pace.
They're stalling.
No pace. Oh, we got to get a takedown here. It doesn't matter. He's got the riding time locked up. All right.
Oh. Final score, 4-2. Favorite Warburg.
What a marathon. Holy
yeah, it was.
Crap. All right, I'm going to finish it up here at heavyweight. 26-3, favor of the Knights. All right, this should be Dancy then.
We got Vogel at heavyweight for us. You got an eye poke there.
All right, Vogel, another one of our seniors. Like I said, he's filled in at multiple different weights throughout the career. His career, he's had some good moments at heavyweight this year. Actually pinned a pretty highly ranked opponent at Cornell. He's beaten some other really good kids as well this year. Him and Reeves went to an overtime match. This is crazy.
He's fearless. That's the thing. At the end of the day, he's fearless.
Yeah,
Greco All-American.
Yep.
You know,
I'd be careful if I was dancing here pushing in. I'm not going to lie. Oh!
Vogel went for it, but. They have always liked about Vogel, too. He kind of reminds me of a guy in a bar fight. Like, he's just going to just spit the blood out of his mouth and just be like, is that all? Come on, let's keep fighting.
Yeah. One of the kids that's done everything he's been asked to do here over the last several years. It's a hell of a competitor. All right, 2-0 then. A little quick action here to get out from bottom would be great. Something worth noting too, Worm. I believe we do have a makeup duel with Simpson next Wednesday at UD. Cradle nothing.
Cradle the Vogel flows with it.
There should not have been back points, and there wasn't. So good job, Brady, getting out. But yeah, again, we do wrestle Simpson.
One of the last shout outs I got tonight too of former Loras wrestler Luke Selichek. Taking the Waller Catholic Eagles alongside former Loras alum Joel Allen to the district tournament. They got three guys going tomorrow, so wish those guys best of luck.
All right, let's see here. Minute and 19 seconds, 2-1 in favor of Dancy.
Coach Travis Andrews is tuning in. He's been sending me some messages here, too, so wishing him and the Cougars best of luck.
I'll be seeing his ugly mug in the morning.
I'm still thinking about heading out there tomorrow, you know, show some former alumni love. Skull Cougs.
All right, 59 seconds left to go. Outside shot here by Warburg. All right, 39 seconds left to go here. Both wrestlers kind of stand in the middle. Like I said, Vogel's going to want to – he wants to compete with you up top. You know what I mean? He wants to be – he likes, slide by as well. I mean, obviously when you're giving up 35, 45 pounds at a clip, it's not ideal to try to start taking shots underneath guys like this. So
absolutely. So that's why those slide bys do work for Vogel. This guy's going to try taking shots here. For a second there, he was trying to do some RBY stuff with his hand behind his arm, but – I don't think you got to worry about that in heavyweight too often, but. Vogel chooses down here to start the second period.
Looking for a quick escape. 29 seconds of riding time here. All right, Vogel's able to try to get his feet under him here. Like I said, it's tough. Leave it on it. Yeah. You know, here's just the unfortunate part when you're wrestling up and giving up this much weight, because really it's just tough to build up when that guy's got all of his weight across your back like that. There we go.
Yeah, that's a lot of weight to carry.
Knees together. All right. Looking better. Trying to get out. That should be a count, but.
I mean, there's guys wrestling each other that are not even within 4 ounces of each other, realistically. Vogel's given up about 40, so put that in perspective.
All right, fresh start. So Dancy's up to over a minute, and almost to a minute and a half of riding time right now. So
seconds left here in the second.
Oh, Vogel's able to kind of escape, roll out.
Escape.
It was like a little. Dancy's trying to go up top.
He was trying to just come running in. I don't know if that's smart or not, but hey. Warburg still got riding time. And that's a battle that we lost a lot tonight, too, is the riding time. I mean, there's been a couple matches that have been decided by riding time.
Correct.
And really should, I mean, got to get those things out of the way.
Nope, you're 100% right, man. And like I said, if you go back and look at the tape, it's kind of like just some small little adjustments. I said, right side ride, ankle ride is like a key all night long for Warburg. So we'll see what they, you know, it's a game of adjustments, and we need to make the adjustments, and they're going to make certain adjustments, and then we go back to battle. So, all right. Nancy goes down. Here, Vogel. Going to work from top. Senior, again, like I said, can't thank him enough for all the hard work he's put in over the years.
Be nice to see him get this W and come out with a win.
All right, so that's going to be a 3-2 lead, 4-2, though. With riding time, it's not locked up. We need some takedowns. See, Dancy pushes in. Again, though, do you see when he immediately when we go to the slide by, he knees down. It's a good game plan, but we just got to execute better. All right, he's looking for it. Good job by Vogel getting out of that. Let's see what he's got some magic here in the next minute and 15 seconds. Another slide by attempt. One minute left to go here in the duel with the Warburg Knights. They've come in.
They came ready to scrap.
Yeah. There's no doubt. 43 seconds here.
Like I preached this the entire duel. Momentum is it's a word I can't really say on TV right now.
A little bit rough there with the head bump. But Dancy's got the 4-2. He is effectively dancing now. Mm-hmm. 10 seconds.
If I'm Vogel, let's just go for something here. Let's party. Hey, let's take a shot there. I like that.
Too little too late, though, today, unfortunately. Warper came in here. He took 9 out of 10 bouts today.
That's a tough one. But, hey, let's get regionals and let's move forward.
Yeah, so, again, we keep talking about this. Warper came in. They were prepared to wrestle in a hostile environment. They brought a great crowd tonight for this duel. And they really, they beat us in all the aspects that they needed to. They controlled us where they needed to. But I have no doubt in my mind that we'll be ready to go for regionals. This coaching staff with Coach Miller and these other guys, they just know how to peak. They know when to peak. And over the last 4+ years, they've shown time and time again that, you know what, they're going to be ready when it's time.
Absolutely. So hopefully here we can make some adjustments and let's move forward in the next couple weeks.
Thank you, everybody out there, for listening in tonight and watching our broadcast. Our student broadcasters did an excellent job from start to finish. We thank them for all their hard work. All right, 29-3, Wartburg Knights. Thanks, Worm. It's been another great year on the broadcast, and I appreciate being able to do this with you. So
likewise, buddy. It's been a lot of fun.
All right. Have a great night, everybody. Take
care. Go Ducks.